Hey guys,
and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 11 of Corch Plays Modded Minecraft. And like always, I got myself a lot of cool stuff planned and I did a little bit of work between the episode. But before we get started, let's quickly mention the person that I added today. The statue is Coletra. Coletra is another active IRC user and someone who has been following me on Twitter and been giving me some advice on my Let's Play. So thank you very much, you deserve a statue in my base, and like always, just comment down below if you want to have a chance to have your own statue here. Pretty cool. So first of all, I will quickly mention what I did between the episodes. Isn't that much today, but I do want to get started setting up the rest of the stuff that I actually did work for this episode. So I need to, you know, I might be derping up a little bit today because it's been a little while before I actually played. Had to, you know, do a lot of configuration with the world, because at the moment I got my world running on a server provided by Aim2Game. Thank you very much. So yeah, it's pretty cool. So that means that my world is now 24/7 online, which is amazing for both things like backups on the world and things like mining and processing, because that will run even when I'm not online. But most importantly, performance-wise, because at the moment I am getting a solid above 60 frames per second, with a very rare occasional drop below 60 when looking into this direction because of all these pipes. But other than that, it isn't doing that bad. It's pretty cool. So first of all, I extended my random junk chest quite a lot. Pretty much I replaced it with a impulse item ducks, so the transfer from the buffer chest to the actual provided chests is a lot higher. And I added a lot more adjustable chests in general, so I am able to store a lot more because I believe I only had these five, and well, I only had half a chest left, so I decided just to future proof it a bit, let's get enough space. Then on this floor, I believe I did this between the episode, I added the alloy smelters. Pretty much I'm now able to auto-craft custom alloys, both electrical steel, energetic alloy, vibrant alloy, solarium, and pulsating iron, which is pretty cool. And there's always room for improvement, so I can always add more to this system. And I don't believe I did this between the episodes? No, I don't think so. But pretty much this is my auto-crafting or auto-processing for things that need to be either pulverized or used in a redstone furnace or my induction smelter. For example, things like Invar and hardened glass. Just using that in this thing. Pretty cool. There was something I wanted to mention. Can I recall what? Oh yeah, that's it. If you are wondering like how on earth does all of this stuff work with my logistics pipes and everything, which you probably would only ask either if you haven't played with this mod in a long while or, you know, are new to my channel, because a couple of days ago I started a brand new tutorial series involving logistics pipes, where I will be explaining, starting from the very basics of logistic pipes. So things like, let's see, what do I got? Things like the logistics pipe controller and basic pipes and such. And then I will be moving up to very advanced setups like I got in my base right here, having to do with auto crafting and power transport. I believe there's also fluid transport, but I haven't looked into that yet, but I will definitely do that. Auto crafting, processing, all that kind of cool stuff, yeah. Amazing. Oh yeah, and I added another layer of crafting tables just because I was already running out of space right here. So yeah, pretty cool. So let's get started with the rest of the episode because I want to, you know, set some stuff up. So between the episodes, I did a lot of work preparing the rest of the things that I actually wanted to do this episode. Like I said, I already mentioned it a couple of times in a couple of previous episodes, but it's time to actually get working on it. I'm talking, of course, about some farms. Yes, I created myself two fancy places. One dedicated to nether stuff, like shown right here, and one dedicated to normal crops. This isn't done yet. I still need to add some fancy pathways to it and add some of these slopes like I got on the side of this thing. Also some pathways here and all. But the main idea of this building is here. I also added things like glass and the fancy chiseled bricks. These are chiseled obsidian nether bricks, so normal nether bricks with a chisel. And this is mossy cobblestone. I don't think I actually showed you guys that a second ago. Hold on, let me dig through here. I set up this thingy, an automatic mossy cobblestone generator. Pretty much just an igneous extruder and an item or a fluid transposer hooked up to my water supply behind here. As you can see, pretty cool. And that thing is just pretty much, you know, infusing water with, or infusing cobblestone with water, generating mossy cobblestone. Pretty fancy if you ask me. So today, like I said, I want to get working on the farms. My main idea is to have Gany's Nether farms, or Gany's Nether's ores right here, these three at least. And then here I will be able to farm stuff like, what's it called again? Nether wards, that's the one. But this will be mostly manual, because I'm not expecting that I will need a lot of these things. But if I ever do, then I can always change it in the future. And then right here, I will be automating the things, because I already made the farming stations for them. They are surprisingly difficult to make, so I'm kind of happy that I actually got them right here. But yeah, that's pretty cool. So I hope I will be able to actually make this thing work. Yeah, pretty cool. Let me actually get some dirt to make this look a bit better. And then get working on actually setting this thing up. Because I believe I had an ender chest already dedicated to this. That I, for some reason, put back in my system. One day or another. I also made myself some fluctuating item ducts. As far as I know, these are item ducts that are able to transfer both items and redstone flux. Which is, well, exactly the thing that I want in this situation. So let's see if I can actually set this up properly. I assume this will connect. Yes, it does. So my idea is to connect all of these. And I already have water underneath these, just so I can keep my crops growing. Which is, of course, the thing that you want to have happen. Oh, there we go. Then what I will probably do is run it along like so, then across the middle. I really hope I have enough, because I did not calculate this, because I hate calculating stuff, because it's a game and I want to play as I go. But it appears to be just fine. Then all I need to do, I think, is add a power source. And this thing is indeed actually getting power from my main base. That is also something I still need to work on. Getting more power into my... generating more power. Because I only got the 10 windmills... not windmills. Solar panels currently set up. And, you know, it might be cool to actually get working on a better power method. A couple of episodes ago, someone suggested I get into the calculator mod a bit more. Because they said it had... some method of power generation, but I honestly have no clue yet. I know the developer of calculator a little bit, so I might be able to ask him that. But otherwise, I'm sure I will be able to find out on my own. So let's see. Let's finish this. I believe all I need to do is add this sorting ender chest. And then make this thing output to the top. What do you know? It's working! What? Really now? I actually got this to work? That's awesome! That was surprisingly simple. So, if I did it correct, these things will only be able to go in here. Yes, they do. And please say you aren't going to try to go into the Tesseract, because if that's the case... Oh, yeah. That's awesome. So let me quickly sleep through the night and I will be able to set up the rest of the farm. Alright, so the first thing that I most likely want to farm automatically is my strawberries. Mainly just for, you know, because I can, because I don't really think that I'm, you know, farming or needing these strawberries anymore that much. And I quickly added the other crafting of diamond hose. So I should be able to just do this. And not this. And I believe it will take care of that automatically if I actually have enough strawberries. Let's see. Strawberries. Let me quickly request a stack more. There we go. And then, perfect. So let's see, what other stuff do I got? Do I have carrots? I do. And do I have potatoes? I do. So that's at least two more things I will be able to farm. Let's see. Diamond hose. Oh, not right there. Alright. So like I said, next up are the potatoes. Easy as that. And I do need to make sure to actually lock them just in case they ever run out. They will still know, like, okay, you have to put potatoes in there. So that leaves me with two empty spots. And I'm wondering, do these things also work with sugarcane? Because that's not something I have actually tested. And if they do, then that's awesome. But if they don't, then I will probably have to find a different solution. So let's see. If they would work with sugarcane, I would assume that they don't need something like a hoe or whatever. But, you know, I can try. What happens if I do this? Okay, that does seem to work. And if I do this, will this harvest it? No idea if it will actually or not. So, maybe it needs to be tree high or whatever. Again, this is why I, you know, test things while I'm playing. No seeds. I got that, yes. Because it is able to plant, apparently. Yellow. No? Let me figure something out. Oh, hey, it does actually work. It just needs a diamond hoe in this thing to actually break it, which is something I don't quite understand, because why on earth would it need a hoe? Because it's not actually hoeing anything. Yeah. Stuff that doesn't make sense. That's one of them. So let's see. Probably gonna quickly set up a little area for this to actually work. So let's see. Like there. And then, what would be best? I guess it really doesn't matter if I just do it like this. And then just put myself a lot of water in this to actually make this all work. Which is pretty cool. I do need to make sure that this thing is patched up. Do it there. Just like that. And it is actually able to plant a lot more now, which is amazing. There we go. And it is indeed almost out of sugarcane. Like that then. Do I have any more sugarcane in my system? Oh. I got more than plenty of sugarcane in my system. Which should be here any second. Lock and lock. There we go. Sugarcane farm. Set up and ready to go. Then what else do we got? I mean, we got cotton, but I'm not quite sure how well this will work. Because will it also... Well, you need to right-click these things. So I'm not sure if it will actually break it when it's like at this stage or not. So, I mean, I can try. Do I got any cotton seeds? I got like a bit. So I'll see if this works. I'll try to break a little bit more though. Not more door, but more dough. Yeah, a little bad, sorry. let's see, there we go. More of them. Diamond hoe. Get rid of that torch. So let's see, does this work? Well, okay. Planting works. That's good. Okay, and don't need to do that. So now, I mean, I guess I can use bone meal. Might work. Or at least give it a try if it works. Because that would be pretty awesome if it does. Like, will it actually harvest this stuff? It appears to be so. Oh, wow. That is something I'm honestly impressed by. I did make sure to set these all to push, though. So, something I don't need to forget. So, top push. That's awesome. Now I'm able to actually farm things like cotton and such, too, automatically. How smart are these things? Like, I wouldn't expect them to be that smart. I mean, most mods that I know that add stuff like farming functionality for that don't really know when to, you know, right click or something, but GG, Ender.io, really proud of you. You're really outdone yourself today. Impressive. So yes, this is all working now. This will take a little bit more to actually get all the seeds that I need, but I mean, it's working, so what more do I want? I believe I can break these when they are pink. Because that will mean that they are able to actually plant more. There we go. Now they are all locked properly. So now I can get working on the nether stuff. So I already sorted out the materials that I actually need for this. Or the things that I want to farm. Mostly. Let me quickly sort my junk though. There we go. And this. There we go. So I got myself blazing cactoids. Hell bushes, glowing reeds, and quartz berries bushes. I most likely wouldn't be using hell bush seeds because they are allow you to farm lava, and I got myself a lava pump set up, so that is, you know, kind of redundant if you ask me. So then I will be able to farm quartz berry bushes, blazing cactoids, and where is the other thing? And I have three. Where are the reeds? Oh, there we go, glowing reeds. So, I believe all of these need to be near lava, in one way or another. So let me quickly get myself a lava supply set up right here, and I will be right back. Alright, so I think this will work. So first of all, I will need to fill in all these blank spots with lava. Because, well, yeah, just the way that they work as normal crops need water to actually function, most of these things require lava. Not all of them, so that's pretty cool, but I mean, most of them do. So, oh wow, don't stand in the lava. So what I most likely will also be doing is quickly getting my saw, there we go, and get myself some covers. I hope I'm actually getting enough. Because I don't want to actually step in the lava. So I'm just putting a cover on top of them, so it will look kinda nice, at least better than normal. And I will still be able to actually use this. So then what I need to do is get myself a diamond hoe. I believe you have to use gold or diamonds, and I'm really not, you know, low on diamonds. So then you can able to actually till the netherrack. Just like that. As you can see, it is getting turned into this darker color, which means there is lava nearby. Awesome. And then I can just put the quartz berry seeds on there. Quartz berry seeds allow you to very slowly but surely farm quartz berries. Quartz berries, and in turn nether quartz. So that's actually pretty cool and kind of useful if you ask me. So then I need to do the same in this cross pattern with lava, and you can kind of imagine like what things in Minecraft work in a cross pattern. And no, it's not cactus, because normal cacti don't require water. It is indeed sugar cane, or in this case it is called glowing reeds. Because that allows you to actually grow glowstone. How cool does that sound? No more annoying trips to the nether, which is something I really don't like to do anyway. Not that much going to the nether in this world, because there are a lot of very powerful monsters out there that I have already countered a few times, and that does not make me very happy. So yeah, so for now I only got one glowing reed, which is a shame, but I guess it will be sufficient to get started. And then again, I will be putting covers on them as I go, so that's going to be pretty sweet. Get my ender tank back. There we go. So then right here, I will be planting my Blazing Cactoids. Blazing Cactoids are... Well, they act kind of like cacti, as they are not able to be placed next to a block. So if I would try to place them here, you would, you know, see that I'm not able to do it as I'm holding right click. But I am actually able to place them one block away from there, because, well, this is not surrounded by a block. So that's pretty cool. So slowly but surely, I will be able to expand my farm right here to actually get a proper, yeah, farm going. I do hope that this lava will not ignite this wood or anything, because if I go back into my world someday and I see like half my base burned down and everything right here, then I know my farm is being a bit contagious. Yeah, not that good. So, I mean, this does seem to be working just fine. Like, an episode without any issues so far. That is really rare for me. So let's see what else I can do. Oh, wow, guys. I just realized I'm already at the 20-minute mark. Holy crap, that went fast. Well, I guess that means that I will be doing the same thing I do with the end of every episode. And no, it's not trying to take over the world. I do that at the beginning of every episode. Wahaha. No. It is wrapping up the actual episode. So, like always, I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below if you enjoyed something specifically or have any suggestions for the future. Like always, if you know, if you like the episode, you know what to do. Hit that little thumbs up button. And also, if you didn't like it, you know what to do otherwise. Be sure to check out my blog, my website, and again, special thanks to IntoGame for providing me or the server that I'm actually currently playing on. If you are interested in a server from them, you can use my affiliate code down in the description below to get either 10% off for life or 25% off your first month. So thank you very much, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, guys.